You're the wind in my sails. You're the pull of the sea. You're the wish in the well. You're my faithful belief. If the whole wide world was offered to me, still you'd be all I need.
When we first got the diagnosis, I was pretty scared. I didn't know if this was something that she was going to die from.
We got our diagnosis of HNRNPH2 and a whole bunch of letters after that. We had never, of course, heard of it before. And at 17, we seriously questioned whether or not we'd ever get a diagnosis. We wondered if the medical science would ever catch up with Emma.
My daughter Morgan was diagnosed 2.5 years ago, and we've been on a quest with other families to find a cure for this ultra-rare genetic disorder.
Just know you're all I need.
There's no way that anybody's going to be able to do this on their own. We all have to work together, and we have to use all of our resources that we have, and that includes the parents, the clinicians, the researchers, all working together to keep moving the field forward.
We believe with our hearts and souls that every patient deserves a treatment, everyone. And as a biotech industry, we have a responsibility to make sure that each patient is treated, even if it's 5 patients worldwide or 5,000 or 50,000 patients worldwide.
I have an overarching goal throughout the course of my career to really move the needle on therapy for neurological diseases, especially in kids.
The new key word in the medical field is collaboration. We are so fortunate and lucky to have the collaboration between our doctors in Israel and New York and St. Jude's Children's Hospital and countless other doctors that are all collaborating together to help us find our goal.
It really is team science. We are going to get there much faster if we allow people with real deep expertise to do their thing that they're really expert in.
The best team is being built now to bring this treatment research forward. Our secret is caring. We just care.
The youngest individual we have is 2 years old, and the oldest we have is 37. And as we continue to see them grow up, we want to be able to learn more from them. We call this a natural history study.
That natural history study is critical. That Dr. Bain has that you can get as many patients enrolled in that natural history as you can.
There's this window that we need of research and development to even get to starting to look at a cure.
What's exciting is that we have been able to model the HNRPH2 mutations that are found in the kids in systems that we can study in the lab. So this gives us a platform as we begin to design therapeutic interventions where we can test them before they go back into clinical trials in children.
When we got the diagnosis, it didn't really occur to me that there could be this incredible research that was happening. We have been astounded how they are racing forward to get answers.
It's just been amazing to have that community and to feel that we have the support and to have this wonderful group that is working on research and working on connecting people.
This is a team effort, and it's the HNRNPH family.
We're so blessed and fortunate that this is the group that we've landed in, because these people are on fire.
We're chipping away at a very big problem and providing the data and the foundation that others are going to be able to also build on so that we can drive research forward.
The mission of the Yellow Brick Road Project is to reach families all across the globe.
We need you. Every family, every child that's experiencing this, we have to be together. I'm fully confident that if we can provide the resources that they need, that we're going to get to the end of this game with a cure.
You're the wind in my sails. You're the pull of the sea. You're the wish in the well. And my faithful belief. If the whole wide world was offered to me, still you'd be all I need. Oh, you'd be all I need.